Our day two began with the Insight team of Stephen Seeley and Chris Anastasio targeting the inductive automation ignition. They were able to get code execution through an information leak and a deserialization bug. This earned them $25,000 and 25 points towards Master of Pwn. Next up, the team from Clarity researched, used an arbitrary DLL loading bug, along with a directory traversal bug, to get code execution from the Schneider Electric EcoStruxure Operator Terminal Expert. This earned them $20,000 and 20 Master of Pwn points. The flashback team of Pedro Ribeiro and Radek Damjanski were up next. They were targeting the Rockwell Automation Factory TalkView SE in the HMI category. They actually used a multi-bug chain to get their code execution along with continuation on the target. This earned them $25,000 and 25 more Master of Pwn points. Our next competitors were Tobias Sharnowski, Nicholas Breitfield, and Ali Abbasi, targeting the inductive automation ignition in the control server category. They were able to successfully demonstrate code execution, however the bug they used had been previously reported. This counts as a partial win, but it did earn them 12.5 Master of Pwn points. The crew from the Clarity research team returned, this time targeting the inductive automation ignition in the control server category. They got their code execution working and quickly, however they also used a bug that had previously been reported. Again, this counts as a partial win and earns them 12.5 Master of Pwn points. The Insight team returned for the afternoon session, this time targeting the Schneider Electric EcoStruxure Operator Terminal Expert. Unfortunately, they could not get their exploit working within the time allotted. Making his Pwn2Own debut, Ben McBride of Oak Ridge National Laboratory set about targeting an information disclosure bug on the Iconix Genesis 64. Unfortunately, Ben was not able to get his bug working within the allotted time frame. Ben returned to closeout day two with a successful demonstration against the Rockwell Automation Factory TalkView SE. However, the bug he used had been previously reported. He still earns 12.5 points towards Master of Pwn and demonstrated some great research. We certainly expect great things from him in the future. So that wraps up day two. We've awarded more than $180,000 total and more than 200 Master of Pwn points. Currently, the flashback team is in the lead with 75 points. Following that, Tobias Sharnowski, Nicholas Breitfield, and Ali Abbasi have 62.5 points. The Insight team has 42.5 points. The Clarity research team has 37.5 points. Fabius Artrell and Ben McBride both have 12.5 points. At this point, Master of Pwn is pretty much anyone's game, because we have a lot of demonstrations set for day three. Be sure to come back tomorrow for the final day of Pwn2Own Miami for 2020 and see who gets crowned Master of Pwn.